scholars, how are you all? I hope you are doing fine. Okay children, so now we are going to start with our new chapter, which is chapter number 8, birds. Yes, we have seen different types of birds flying around us, correct? So today we are going to study about birds. I know this is a new Yes, this is a new topic for you, so it will be exciting to learn. Okay, so let us begin. So, what is the big idea of the chapter? Birds are a group of living things that have special features. Yes, we all know that birds can fly, so it is obviously a special features which we don't have. So now we are going to study about birds and the things to learn, which things we are going to learn about birds. Firstly, we are going to see about the feathers of the birds, then the beak of the birds, then about the feet of the birds, then homes of birds. Yes, so these are the different things which we are going to study in this chapter about birds. Okay, so let us begin. Most birds can fly with the help of their wings. Yes, we all have seen that mostly all the birds, they fly with the help of their wings. They have lightweight bodies that also help them to fly. Yes, so the body of the bird is very lightweight. The birds are very light in weight so that they can fly easily. Yes, then the mouth of a bird is called a beak. Yes, we have seen that there are different kinds of beak different birds have. They do not have any teeth, so birds don't have teeth, they have beak. They have two legs to move on land. So mostly all the birds have two legs to walk on the land. When they're walking on the land, then they have two legs and they fly with the help of the wings. We can identify different birds by looking at their beaks and feathers. Yes, we identify the birds by the beak, by the feather, and also by the color of the feather or the color of the bird's body. Yes? Okay. Now, amazing fact. That is, did you know? Birds spend a lot of time cleaning and rearranging their feathers with their beak. This is called pruning. Okay, so we have seen that birds, they arrange their feathers with the help of the beak. Yes, so they love doing this. So most of the time of the day, they spend in cleaning and rearranging the feathers. Okay, now we are going to start with the feathers of the birds. We have seen that birds have different types of feathers and different colors of feathers. Yes? So, a bird's body is covered with three different kinds of feathers. Okay, so the feathers are also divided into three types. So, let us see. So, the first one is the body feather. Yes, can you see in the image the body feather? Where the body feather is located? Yes. Then the down feather. Can you see where the down feather is located? Yes. And then the flight feathers. Okay. So we can see the flight feathers. Now you see the body feather. The shape of the body feather is also different. The shape of the down feather is also different. And the shape of the flight feather is also different. Yes. So now we will see them one by one. What is the use of these feathers? Let us see one by one. Okay, So first is the flight feathers. First we will study about flight feathers. So from the name only we can identify that the flight feathers, they are found on the wings and they help the birds to fly. Yes, flight feathers, they help the birds to fly. And where are they located? They are found on the wings. Yes. Then the down feathers. Now we will study about down feathers. They are soft and fluffy and help to keep the body of the bird warm. So they are soft and fluffy. And what is the use of down feather? To keep the body of the bird warm. Warm means hot. So, to maintain the temperature of the bird's body, down feathers are useful. Nestlings have a lot of down feathers. Nestlings are the baby birds. They have a lot of down feathers. Okay. Now, the third type of feather is the body feather. They cover the body and give shape to the body of the bird. The body feathers are of different colors and shapes. Yes, we have seen that the feathers are of different color and different shape. So the body feathers, they give shape of the body of the bird. Okay, so let us one more time recall what are the uses of flight feathers. So flight feather is used for flying. Down feathers, they are used to control the body temperature or to keep the bird warm. And then the body feathers, they are used to give shape to the body. Give shape to the body of the bird. Okay, now we see that the birds fly. So, there is a pattern in which the birds fly. So, let us see that. Wings help birds to fly. When a bird wants to fly, it flaps its wing upwards called an upstroke and downward called a downstroke. Yes, so if they want to fly, they will use these two patterns. That is upward, if the wings are moving upwards, it is known as upstroke. And if the wings are moving downwards, it is known as downstroke. So let us see this with the help of the image. So can you see the upstroke? The feathers, the wings, they are moving in the upward direction. And when the wings are in down direction, then it is known as downstroke. So, with the help of upstroke and downstroke, the birds fly in the air. Okay, children, I hope you all enjoyed this new topic and you all learned something new. Yes, so rest of the chapter we are going to continue in our next video. Till then, you all read this much. Take care and bye-bye.